السلام عليكم طلابنا الأعزاء، أهلا وسهلا بكم. Let's get back to hepatitis C virus or hepatitis virus type C that was skipped in previous lecture. Hepatitis C virus originally, or the origin name or the birth name is non-A non-B serum hepatitis. Hepatitis C virus belong to flaviviridae. This family has many viruses which is responsible for different viral disease such as dengue fever virus, yellow fever virus, Zika virus, and hepatitis C virus, and Japanese encephalitis virus. The morphology of this virus, it's enveloped virus with envelope glycoprotein 1 and envelope glycoprotein 2 that project from envelope of this virus. Also, it contain capsid, like other viruses, capsid protein or core protein. And the genome of hepatitis C virus is positive single strand RNA, meaning these genome serve as mRNA. The reservoir of hepatitis C virus is man, but can be transmitted experimentally to chimpanzee. The main characteristic or the main feature of hepatitis C virus genome is highly mutable. Highly mutable, meaning this virus has several or many clade. Phylogenetic member or phylogenetic species, which is called clade. Because hepatitis C virus, why the genome of hepatitis C virus is highly mutable? Because it's RNA virus and almost of RNA virus lack the efficient proofreading ability as it replicates. Almost, why can repeat the question, why the genome of hepatitis C virus is highly mutable? Because the genome of the hepatitis C virus is RNA, and almost RNA viruses are mutable because it's lack efficient proofreading ability. Proofreading ability meaning ability of this virus to correct the mutation. If the virus exposed to mutation, it's able to correct this mutation by certain enzyme that contained in this virus. So what are the transmission route that can be used by this virus? There are several strategies can be used by this virus for transmission. The first, by blood transfusion. And there are many groups are risky for blood transfusion, such as thalassemic patient, and hemophilic patient and chronic anemic patient. Strategies number two, sharing contaminated syringe or other sharp or cutting objects such as nail clippers, razor blades, surgical instruments, and instrument used for tattooing and acupuncture. All these tools or instrument when are contaminated with the hepatitis B virus, it's responsible for transmission of this virus. Also, other technique or other strategies from an infected mother to her baby during pregnancy, meaning when pregnant women has exposed to virus, hepatitis B virus, during the first or second trimester, this virus can transmit to her baby. As well as this technique, other technique having a protected sex with an infected person, a rare form of infection. Now, the clinical feature of hepatitis C virus. Hepatitis C virus can occur acute form or clinical or chronic form or both. In acute form of hepatitis C virus, the symptoms include loss of appetite, nausea, tiredness, fever, abdominal pain, and jaundice, and alcohol intolerance. All these feature or these clinical feature are related with the acute hepatitis C virus. And when the immune system or immune response cannot be able to kill or prohibit hepatitis C virus, the hepatitis C virus progress into a chronic form. Then the patient is called chronic carriers of hepatitis C virus, are at risk of chronic liver disease, which is cause progressive damage to the liver, meaning the hepatocyte are necrosis. Serious complication of chronic liver disease, such as cirrhosis, and there are other complication of chronic liver disease, or sequelae or extra hepatic manifestation, such as vasculitis, cryoglobulinemia type 2, glomerulonephritis. The cirrhosis may not become apparent until 20 to 50 years after infection with this virus. People with cirrhosis may go on to develop liver failure or liver cancer, hepatocellular carcinoma. This scheme show the progress of hepatitis C virus. Hepatitis C virus in acute illness from 20 to 30% with the symptoms meaning the patient, there are 20 to 30 percent of acute infection appear symptoms. And from 50 to 25% clearance of hepatitis C virus. And with a rare event, may be led to fulminant hepatitis. It's a rare syndrome. Chronic infection that account 75 to 85% of hepatitis C virus infection. In a chronic infection, there are may lead to extrahepatic manifestation such as vasculitis, cryoglobulinemia type 2, and glomerulonephritis, and polyarteritis nodosa. And the patient appear with purpuric lesion. Or led to a chronic active hepatitis that become cirrhosis, which is account 10% to 20%, which appear over 20 years after primary or after infection with the hepatitis C virus. When the patient has cirrhosis, that may be led to decompensated cirrhosis. There are two types of cirrhosis. Compensated cirrhosis, when the liver is still able to serve as a job or doing a job, while in decompensated cirrhosis, when the liver lost his job. Then the decompensated cirrhosis, 5 years survival rate of 50%, that may lead to hepatocellular carcinoma, account 1% to 5% per year. It's progressive of hepatitis infection, and it's biological driver of hepatocellular carcinoma. This is the healthy liver, and when this liver exposed to hepatitis C virus, and the hepatitis C virus replicate in hepatocyte and cover cell, then after acute infection, the hepatitis C hepatitis C virus lead to chronic infection. In chronic infection, there are inflammation and necrosis, cellular growth signals, resistance to apoptosis, oxidative stress, and metabolic disorder. All these events are related with the chronic HCV infection. In cirrhosis stage, also there are many events related with this stage. Fibrogenesis, meaning formation of fibrin, hypoxia, inadequate blood flow that led to hypoxia, genetic instability, because genetic disorder of genome, impaired xenobiotic metabolism that led to accumulation of genotoxin. Genotoxin meaning this substances may cause toxic to the gene, immunity evasion, and LBS of microbiota are translocated from intestinal microbiota. All these events are associated with the cirrhosis that led to hepatocellular carcinoma. Also, the same events of hepatitis C virus with the chronic and cirrhosis and led to multifocal hepatocellular carcinoma. The laboratory finding of hepatitis C virus infection. The first biochemical enzyme that raised after infection with the hepatitis C virus is ALT, ALT, alanine transaminase, or original, it's called GPT. This is nearly specific with the liver or hepatocyte enzyme. Also, we can use the serological technique to diagnose the hepatitis C virus infection, such as anti-hepatitis C virus antibody can be detected in 50 to 70 of patients at onset of symptoms. Meaning specificity or sensitivity of this test is about 50 to 70 of percent. Whereas other antibody appear in onset of illness of hepatitis C virus infection, and the other antibody appear in delayed 3 to 6 weeks after infection with the hepatitis C virus. These antibodies are directed against core envelope 1, non-structural 3, non-structural 4 protein, and tend to be relatively low in titer. Oh, these antibody which relatively low in titer, meaning low concentration of these antibodies. Also, we can use molecular technique that based on the nucleic acid, such as reverse transcriptase, real-time PCR, detect the presence of circulating hepatitis C virus RNA and are useful for monitoring patient on antiviral therapy, which is called viral load. Viral load technique, meaning estimation of the genome of hepatitis C virus or other hepatitis that need to antiviral therapy such as HIV, HPV, meaning estimation of RNA in the serum of the patient which or who undergoes with antiviral therapy. Nucleic acid assay also are used to genotype hepatitis C virus isolate, meaning the hepatitis C virus has many genotype. It's about 1 to 7 genotype of hepatitis C virus, because it has, or the genome is RNA virus, and it is highly mutable genome. The therapy protocol of hepatitis C virus is a combination two drugs like ribavirin with the pegylated interferon post used to cure rate and reduce the risk or relapse. It's very, very important, and the patient who recover from hepatitis C virus may be relapsed with hepatitis C virus. So what's the ribavirin? Ribavirin is a guanosine ribonucleic analog used to stop viral RNA synthesis and viral mRNA capping. So it is the mechanism, or the mechanism of ribavirin is a nucleoside inhibitor. So why we add pegylated materials into interferon? Pegylated can be added into interferon to make interferon last longer in the body. There are used to treat both hepatitis C and hepatitis B virus. It's very, very important note related with the vaccine manufacturing, vaccine of hepatitis C virus manufacture. Currently, or there are no available vaccine for hepatitis C virus. Why? Currently, there is no vaccination against hepatitis C virus. One reason being that the virus come in many forms. Hepatitis C virus has many forms. Why? Because it has highly mutable genome, the RNA. Therefore, that led to make many forms of hepatitis C virus and constantly mutates, leading to swarms of closely related viral genome sequences referred to quasi-species. Hepatitis D virus, we have studies in previous lecture, and we will move into hepatitis E virus. Enteric, non-A, non-B hepatitis. While hepatitis C virus, original called serum, or non-A, non-B serum hepatitis. While hepatitis E virus, original called enteric non-A, non-B hepatitis. The difference between hepatitis E and hepatitis E virus and hepatitis C virus in the original level, and hepatitis E virus, it's enteric, while hepatitis C virus is serum. Regarding with properties of hepatitis E virus, it's belong Hebe viridae family, and the morphology, there are two variant. The morphology of hepatitis E virus, which are differ from than the other hepatitis viruses morphology, because this virus have two variant. One, it's enveloped virus, and the other is non-enveloped. The genome, it's a single strand RNA, and it's positive. meaning this RNA serve as RNA. Hepatitis E is a foodborne and waterborne disease, while hepatitis C virus is a bloodborne disease. Hepatitis E is a food, while foodborne disease or waterborne disease, while hepatitis C virus is a bloodborne disease. The recognition of zoonotic and bloodborne hepatitis E virus transmission and its ability to persistent in immunosuppressed or immunocompromised individual, it's also alarming. Meaning, some strains of hepatitis E virus is a zoonotic, virus. Meaning, this virus originates from a certain animal. Also, hepatitis E virus, it's also bloodborne hepatitis E virus transmission. It's so alarming, and it's very, very dangerous to a community or to a society of a human being. Hepatitis E virus is mainly found in area with poor sanitation. Therefore, it is waterborne and foodborne hepatitis virus. Hepatitis mainly found in areas with poor sanitation, and it's typically caused by ingesting fecal matter. The three types or variant of hepatitis E virus: naked hepatitis E virus virion and enveloped hepatitis E virus, with the other quasi-enveloped hepatitis E virion. The clinical feature of hepatitis E virus, regarding with incubation period from 2 to 6 weeks in acute, only hepatitis E virus only cause acute infection, or mainly cause acute infection, and there are no carrier, no chronic form of hepatitis E virus, as like hepatitis A virus and unlike hepatitis B and C virus. In acute hepatitis E virus, including clinical signs of hepatitis E virus in acute form: jaundice, malaise, weight loss and loss of appetite, nausea, abdominal pain, fever, hepatomegaly. Some patient may develop dark urine. This is a sign is associated with the raise of bilirubin in serum, conjugated or unconjugated bilirubin. Develop dark urine. It's associated with the conjugated bilirubin, because this bilirubin, this type of bilirubin, this form of bilirubin is water soluble substances. Therefore, it appear in urine. So some patient may develop dark urine, bile stool, due to stagnation of bile pigment, which is called cholestasis, and jaundice, itching, itching due to bilirubin in serum that lead to itching, and in enlarged or tender liver. The onset of clinical symptoms with a sharp rise in serum ALT, as we said, and laboratory diagnosis or a clinical laboratory finding with the hepatitis E virus, hepatitis C virus, sorry, sharp rise in serum ALT level. While in hepatitis, the ALT level or concentration that appear in serum in patient who contracted with the hepatitis C virus, the ALT is raised in onset of illness, an acute of illness, and still progress with fluctuated level along with illness. So, hepatitis E virus RNA may be detected in both serum and stool early in the course of infection. But serum viremia may be difficult to detect by time cases come to clinical attention. Anti-hepatitis E virus IgM titer increase rapidly, while anti-hepatitis E virus IgG antibody titer continue to rise more gradually during the convalescent period. Undetectable anti-hepatitis E virus IgG may persist for months or years. Meaning IgM of hepatitis of anti-hepatitis E virus associated with the acute infection, while and IgG it's associated with chronic, sorry, convalescent patient. The curves related with the biochemical test and serological test associated with hepatitis E virus infection. The ALT raised sharply concentration and may reach to 1,000 international unit per liter in serum or in serum of patient with the hepatitis E virus. While the IgM antihepatitis virus develop with onset or acute infection with the hepatitis B virus and last or decreased in 2 weeks after exposure, while the IgG anti-hepatitis E virus still raised for months or years. Clinically, there is very important notes: hepatitis E virus in pregnant women. The infection with the hepatitis E virus is not only generally a benign self-limited disease, but it can also adversely affect in pregnant women and lead to fulminant hepatic failure, especially during the second and the third trimester, subsequently lowering survival of mother, and there also beside maternal complication. Hepatitis E virus also causes serious consequence to the fetus following transplacental transmission, which varies in severely form of low birth weight, prematurity, mild and ectopic neonatal hepatitis or jaundice at birth with a full recovery to miscarriage, stillbirth, preterm labor, prenatal death or neonatal death soon after birth. All these signs are associated with hepatitis E virus when this virus is transmitted from infected mother or infected pregnant woman into her fetus. Treatment hepatitis E virus is self-limiting and does not result in chronic, as we said in with this video. Therefore, in a chronic hepatitis, therefore, the treatment should be supportive to provide management of the symptoms. Meaning the physician treat or manage the symptoms that related with the hepatitis E virus. Treatment options for chronic hepatitis E include use of ribavirin. It's a rare occur with hepatitis E virus. There is a chronic hepatitis E virus. Mainly, hepatitis E virus cause acute form of illness. Prevention. There are several protocol which is used to prevent hepatitis E virus and control of hepatitis E virus. A vaccine for hepatitis E virus that uses recombinant baculoviruses with the 90% and 95% success rate. Prevention include not consuming contaminated food and water. It's a fecal to transmit of this hepatitis virus, or this fecal for responsible for transmission of hepatitis E virus. Avoiding travel to area with the hepatitis E virus, especially poor state or bad hygiene or poorly sanitation area. When water contamination seems to be the cause of epidemic, measure to filter the water of hepatitis E virus include chlorination of water supplies, also iodinated disinfectant or autoclaving destroy this virus. Thank you for your attention, and I am being ready to reply or answer your any question or any asking that related with this lecture. Thank you very much.